Here is a quick step-by-step guide on how to get started with Symflower to automatically generate unit tests. Hi, I'm Evelyn from Symflower. In this video, we will cover everything you need to know to get started with Symflower. We'll take a look at how to install Symflower in VS Code, how to generate your first unit tests, and we'll go through a short example of how you can use those unit tests in your daily workflow. Symflower is available for a wide range of IDEs. In this tutorial, we're going to use Visual Studio Code, but on our website, you can find in-depth tutorials for other development environments such as IntelliJ or Cocoon. Let's open up Visual Studio Code and hit the extension icon in the menu on the left. To quickly find Symflower, we can use the search bar and simply hit install. All right, that's it. We are ready to generate our first unit tests using Symflower. Symflower is available for Java and Go, and additional programming languages will be available soon. Go ahead and use the voting feature on our website if you're interested in other programming languages. In this tutorial, we're going to use Java, and by the way, all the use code examples are available on our website as well. For this tutorial, we're going to create a function that copies an array of strings from a parameter source to a parameter destination and returns the destination parameter. With that specification in mind, we can already create the first version of our function. Here is the first version of our copy function. It has two string arrays as parameters, source and destination, and it simply returns destination. Of course, that function doesn't yet copy anything, but we can use this stub implementation to generate our first unit tests. To do that, we simply need to save this file, and that's really everything that is required to trigger the Symflower unit test generation. The file tree now shows us that a new file has been created, which is called copySymflowerTest.java. This test case was automatically generated by Symflower and represents the simplest unit test possible for our function. It uses null for both parameters and checks if the function returns null. Remember that our specification tells us to copy one array to the other, so the case where null is used as an input is strictly speaking not defined. That means we should keep an eye on this test as we go along with our implementation, because it should vanish in the process. So let's go ahead and write the first version of our actual implementation. Of course, there are many different ways of how to implement a copy function. We've decided to go with a simple for loop that copies one element after the other. By simply hitting save, Symflower adapts the existing test suite. So let's take a closer look at the generated tests. Symflower has generated 5 unit tests. As you can see, there are 3 failing test cases and 2 passing ones. So let's first look at the 2 passing unit tests. This test copies source with a single null element into destination, which also holds a single null. The result is again an array with a single null element. So this test definitely matches our specification. So let's move on to the second passing test case. This test copies source, an array with no elements, into destination, which is null and returns null. So the current implementation is somewhat incorrect, as the specification tells us to copy one array into another. So we have to adapt our specification and make sure that both input parameters are defined. Let's add a check to our function in case one of the parameters is null, we throw an illegal argument exception. When we save now, we see that our unit test will be updated. The expected value is no longer null, but an illegal argument exception is expected. The test above also expects an illegal argument exception by setting both parameters to null. And the third test copies an empty array to another empty array and expects an empty array as output. So far, everything seems to work according to our specification. Let's look at the last test case here. Symflower has found yet another error, which is an out-of-bounds exception when we try to copy an array with one element to an array with zero elements. We haven't really specified what should happen in that case, and basically there are three different options we could follow. Either we again throw an illegal argument exception if we receive two input parameters of different size, or we allocate a new array for the target array with the correct size. And as a third option, we could only copy those elements that fit into the target array. And the best option here is definitely to talk to our fellow developers to clarify the specification and then adapt the source code accordingly and regenerate the Symflower tests. Working this way ensures that everything works as expected and no edge cases are overlooked. And that's it. You've just learned how to generate unit tests using Symflower. Unit tests help you to catch bugs as early as possible. You've also seen how to use these generated tests to effectively implement the specification. Download Symflower for free to speed up your workflow and let us know about your experience. Thank you for watching. We hope this video was helpful for you. Stay tuned for upcoming videos covering more advanced topics.